Hello, Sagittarius, and welcome to Blunt Sagittarot. My name is Robin, and Sagittarius, today we're going to do your career and finance reading for the month of June 2023. Let's talk about you, baby. Let's see what's going on with your job, with your business. Let's see what's going on in your career and what you need to know. What's coming down the chute? Spirit guides, talk to us. What's going on with the Sagittarius in the month of June with regards to their job, their business, their career? Exchanging gifts, okay? Peace, okay? And a destiny, your fates. The exchanging gifts is all about creating a balance between giving and receiving. The universe might be rewarding you, passing along a gift, but peace is about being at peace. Let's see what that's all about, because this is destiny. This is fated. This is exactly what you want. So let's talk about what's going down. That to me means that you're following the right path. You're doing your soul's purpose, right? Your soul's work. Spirit guides, what up with that? Yeah, the Eight of Pentacles. That's what we start this off with. Oh, and then we have the Eight of Swords. Huh. All right, let's talk about a Sag. And for those of you who are interested, I am doing personal readings. If you want one, the link is in the description box below. That's what I thought. You're definitely on the right path following your soul's purpose here. So you're not, you haven't been led astray. Queen of Wands, up in your power. We got two queens here, though. Could be you. You could have a lot of earth in your chart, but let's see who this other queen is. Because you're the Queen of Wands. Page of Swords. Oh, the Star's in reverse. The Four of Wands. What is going on? Okay, so the Eight of Pentacles tells us that you've mastered your craft. The Eight of Pentacles is just that. Mastering a skill. Mastering a craft and starting to see the progress. Things are starting to progress. Like, let's say you, I don't know, let's say you make and crochet dog hats. Things are starting to progress, you know? You're helping the little pooches stay shady when it's hot outside. You're helping the innocent. And people are liking your service. They're liking your product. So you're doing a good job. It's good quality. That's what the Eight of Pentacles is mastering that. You might have been worried that this wasn't going to work out. I do feel this is a dream. This is something that you've been wanting since childhood. That's why I think, well, I know this is definitely your soul purpose. You're doing what your soul came here to do. You could be living in service to others or just providing excellent service in the industry that you're in. What is the Eight of Swords energy? What do you want to say about that for Sagittarius? The Sun. Yeah. Queen of Wands is upside down. Maybe you were questioning if this was there's a queen. There's three queens here. So three queens in a reading represents conflict. And this is clarifying the Eight of Swords. So there could be pettiness in the office. This could just be not going right. And you've been wondering if you're doing the right thing, if you're making the right decisions, if you're going down the right path. But the Sun represents, again, you're being tested here, Sag. It's like a test of you. That's so silly. I don't know. I was going to say something else, but there's really nothing else to say. You're being tested. This is becoming a master of yourself, controlling and building the solid foundations, following your spiritual enlightenment, sticking to your path, you know. Maybe there have been obstacles and the universe is making sure you want this. Or there could be pettiness at the work office. There could be, you know, office politics. There really is a lot of office politics out there. I don't know why people are like that, but can't we all just get along? But the answer to that question is probably no. Six of Wands and the Knight of Swords. You're giving it a lot of attention, though. Six of Wands is also badass success with the Knight of Swords. I just caught that. What the fuck? Because I was all caught up on the conflict. But let's not worry about the negative. Let's focus on the positive. This is rushing into success. Look at this horse. Maybe you'll come into unexpected wealth, unexpected success. You're getting a lot of attention really quickly. Like, let's say you're making your dog hats and all of a sudden you got 20,000 orders. You're like, holy fuck, I can't do all 20,000 orders. I need to hire some people here. But your skills and your talents are getting recognized in the month of June. And that could create enviness. Maybe that's what all these queens are. They're a little bit upset. Maybe your Instagram followers are going up to a million. You're getting a lot of attention. People are complimenting you. And you know, not everybody is always happy. But there is some kind of conflict with all these queens. But you're not going to let that get you down. You know, we have this Canadian rapper. His name is Chaos. I don't know if you guys, you know, I never really know if like our Canadians are like famous in other areas of the world. But he has a song called Crap Bucket. And it goes, no time to get down because I'm moving on, right? So nobody can get you down. You're just moving on. Listen to Crab Buckets from Chaos if these women or these men or these pettiness get to you in any way, shape, or form. But you're getting a lot of attention. You're getting a lot of success. A lot of things are more moving forward quickly because I just started moving like really fast. It's like, you know, you were putting and then you jumped on the back of the train and now you're flying. Getting a lot of attention. Look at all these eyes. All eyes on you. This Ace of Pentacles says that there's some kind of offer, some kind of new beginning, some kind of, well, there's something here with the Ace of Pentacles. You won't be celebrating. The Queen of Pentacles. And the Two of Cups, there's some kind of partnership being offered to you here. You don't see that coming. So maybe if you're making these hats and, you know, maybe you need money, you need someone to invest the money because you don't have the money to buy all the material. You got a business partner. You got someone offering you some kind of deal. I don't know what I'm talking about, the dog hats. That's kind of a really weird example, but I am. And that's just the example that's coming out of my head. So whatever it is that you're working on here, there's someone who wants to do business with you, Sag. They, like I said, you're getting a lot of recognition. Like, let's say you're an Instagram model. You caught the attention of a model agency here. They want to partner up with you. They want to do business with you. So it is this Queen of Pentacles. I knew you were the Queen of Wands. So this Queen of Pentacles here is caught. You've caught their attention. You've caught their eye. They want to do business with you. And they want to make this happen. You know, maybe they're just a marketing expert and they're going to help you market your hats on Facebook and Google and make it grow even more. So I do believe with this offer, let's talk about this Page of Swords, because the Page of Swords is a studious. Let's say you were a model and now they want to be an actor. Well, you might have to go to acting school to see, you know, how to act. So you're not, you know, those fake actors where they're like really bad and just like, oh my God, you're a bad actor. So you don't want to be that person. You want to be a good actor, but you're a model. So now you got to learn how to act. I don't know. What is the Page of Swords? What is this learning for Sag? What is this? Yep. Holy motherfucker. Sounded like a horse there, but shit. So we have the Emperor and the Empress. Whoa. Sag. This is like the ultimate business partner. This is like the freaking president of the United States of America. What do you got to turn your back on? The Page of Cups. King of Wands in reverse. Who's that? The Page of Pentacles. How many offers are coming towards you? Maybe everybody wants your hat, you know? Kmart wants your hat. Walmart wants your hat. Target wants your hat. Everybody wants your doggy hats here. Things are blowing up for you. But this offer, this partner, whoever this is that wants to do this business with you, oh baby, this is a power couple. This will turn your business, turn your job, turn your career to the next fucking level. This is, I got goosebumps. This is power. If you're a politician, maybe you're running for the United States of America. I don't know, but this is like presidential power here. Maybe you just want to become the president of a country or of a company. Why am I talking about that? I don't know, Sagi, I don't know. But then we have the Star in reverse. Let's talk about that. So there is, this could just represent contract. We got this book, we got this contract. But you got to turn your back on something. Maybe it's your current job, you got to quit. Maybe it's your current supplier for your dog hats. You know, maybe you're using this person's wool and now you got to use the person's wool over here to crochet. Do you crochet with wool? Do you knit? I don't know. I don't make shit. I don't even know how to sew. I don't have those skills. There's the Hierophant. Holy moly. You are definitely leveling up this month. Opportunities coming out the wahoo. Everybody wants your attention. Everybody wants to work with you. What have we tapped in here today? I can't even talk. Let's just say things are flying for you. Things are magical. This is magic. This is wishes, juices, dreams come true. This is like pinch yourself. It's really happening, baby. But this King of Wands is here and he's in reverse. So just be aware of people who might be a little jealous. The King of Wands in reverse is a jealous energy. So like I said, when things really start flying with you, you know, like the most successful people say, you don't need to tell everybody how your successes are. Let them just see. Because when you share your successes, not everybody's happy for you. Not everybody really wants you to be successful. So maybe, you know, don't go posting all over Facebook that you got, you know, the president of the United States is reaching out and he wants you to be his marketing campaign. I don't know why I keep using that, but that's just what this is. This is presidential power. So maybe you're becoming the president of your company or whatever this partnership is, Sag, it's leveling up. But let's talk about the Star in reverse. What is that? What is the Star in reverse here? I'm not even in the States. I don't know. Do you guys have an election coming up? I don't know what's going on, but this is leveling up in your career, seriously. Maybe you're just becoming promoted to, you know, the president of your company or something, but that's serious power. What is the Star in reverse here? Judgment. This is your destiny. You're worried about this. There could be some imposter syndrome. There's a lot of competition. There's the King of Pentacles. Wow. Wow. The King and the Queen of Pentacles, the Emperor and Empress. This is a power business deal. This is going to make your dreams come true, Sag. And the Sun, the Star in reverse makes, it's like I feel imposter syndrome, or if it's not imposter syndrome, wondering if this can be real. Is this going to go the way I want it to go? Is this premature? You know, you don't want to be that person who's like celebrating before the end of the race and then someone comes and passes you and you're like, oh my God, I didn't win even though I thought I win. So you don't want to count your chickens before they hatch. So I feel like you're waiting to celebrate to make sure there's no disappointments, but this is unbelievable. This is leveling up. This is serious power. Your career is going to the next level. It is your destiny. Maybe it is your destiny. All right, that's pretty good reading. Let's grab some oracle messages here for you, Sag, and we'll get back and we'll see how this is going in the month of July. There's a lot going on for you in your career here. Spirit guys, what does Sagittarius need to surrender to? Talk to us. Surrender to the magic of who you are. We all have magic in us, even in the mundane aspects of life. Remember that you are a magical being that comes with the uniqueness that comes from just being you. So just stay true to yourself, because whatever you be doing, you be catching the attention of some important people. Someone is going to take this business or take your career to the next level here. That is for sure. Otter, surrender. Let go of control. Let this happen naturally, Sagittarius. Let it happen naturally. All right. What is the soul card here? What you want to say? What you want to say? What's the soul purpose? What's the soul card? What do you want to say? Talk to us. Talk to us. It's time to decide. So make a decision based on your heart's true desires. Music. Maybe some of you are getting your big break. Your connection to music is healing for yourself and others. Maybe your video goes viral or something. And study. Reading, research, and education help provide confidence and clarity about your career. And that's that Page of Swords energy. So remember, when you're mastering your craft, there's always something new to learn. Only a fool thinks he knows everything. A wise man knows he knows nothing. There's always more to learn. You know, if you are a singer, there's always a better singer out there who can hit those notes that can teach you something, right? So whatever your craft is, if you are crocheting and puppy hats, you know, you can always learn different strategies or different techniques or use different materials. There's always something to learn. So just remember that. Just remember that. Learning never ends. So let's get down to business. Oh no, they want me to grab the energy oracle. Did I grab that? I didn't. Hold on a minute. They want me to. So there's a message they want to pass along to you. Spirit guides. What up with Sag? What up? What's the energy oracle message? What do you want to say here? We got a couple. The temple pack. This is your destiny. The angel of love. Hold on. They love you, Sag. They really love you. The financial constraints. Angel of strength. Storm warning. Huh. What the fuck is this? And then the yin yang. Huh. Have the courage. Financial constraints could signify some kind of financial troubles. The angel of love is stay balanced, follow your heart, do what's best for you. Maybe you need to invest money. The temple path is this is your destiny. This is what it is. But let's talk about this storm warning, these financial constraints. What is this? We'll start with the financial constraints. Are those coming to an end? Is that coming forward? What do you want to say? The tower. Oh, maybe you have to move. Whoa, the devil. Oh, oh my God. Okay. So we're talking about, you know, don't count your chickens before they hatch. Don't spend your money before you get it. This is a message of, you know, it's like you get, you sign a record deal, they give you a signing bonus of 20,000. You spend the 20,000 in a month. I know people who have done that. not from a record deal, but they just get a lump sum. It's just gone in a month. They didn't even invest it. Anyway, let's not get there. That's just my, anyway, that's the sense that I sense here. So don't spend your money before you get it. And when you get a large lump sum, because you're coming into something pretty special here, Sag, just make sure you talk to a financial advisor or invest your money properly, or, you know, don't go about buying, you know, a $200,000 car. And then next thing you know, you can't buy food. And I don't know why that's coming out, but that's what this is. So just be careful with how you spend your money. Don't spend your money before you get it, and don't spend it all before, you know, you want to set yourself up for life and then get your luxuries, right? If you get $1 million, or if you're really generous, maybe you're generous. You get $1 million, and next thing you know, your Aunt Lois is running around with a Ferrari, and your Auntie Debbie is running around in $1 million house. But just make sure that you're set. Just make sure that you're smart with your financial decisions, because I see, I don't see, the cards just told us you might kind of spend the money before you get it, and there might be some regrets there. So just be careful with your spending and just don't spend money before you get it. That's what they want to say, because I feel like you're coming into a lot of money here. All right, Sagittarius. So let's talk about your potential outcome. So when I say potential, there's always free will. You're going to make the decisions you're going to make. And when I say outcome, let's see where you are in July. Let's see how this contract's going. Let's see how this career is going. If it's just a promotion, if it's a new business, if it's a modeling career, music career, let's see how you're doing here. Spirit guides. How's Sagittarius doing in the month of July? Talk to us. Okay. Oh, got the Two of Swords, but we're not quite ready. We only have four cards. We have the Two of Wands. We have the Queen of Swords in reverse. We have the Six of Cups. We have the Queen of Cups. What else we got? We have the Lovers in reverse. There's the Devil. Why does this Devil keep sneaking up on you? There's the King of Pentacles. Watch this King of Pentacles. So we have the Emperor and we have the Empress. So just watch your money, Sag, and make sure that the deal's, like, maybe have a lawyer review this contract, make sure it's fair. The Devil and that King of Pentacles tells me this could just simply represent a Capricorn. And if that's the case, it's the case. You're dealing with the Capricorn. But another level to that is somebody who is out for their own advancement. Someone trying to take advantage of you, giving you a bad contract, using your skills. And they're the ones that benefit from them, profit from them is the word I'm looking for, and not you. So if this is your doggy, you're making your doggy hats and this person wants to invest, it's not 50-50, it's your idea, it's your money, it's your company. Make sure the contract is beneficial to you. Watch your money. That's all I'm going to say there. That's the second time that that warning came out. So watch your money, watch the people who are investing in your money, make sure your accountant's got, you know, make sure you're paying attention, you're going into your QuickBooks or whatever it is that you do. Just pay attention to your moolah. That's what they want to say. I want to see what this Queen of Swords is in reverse. Because this is your future. Your future's looking bright. You're looking out. This is your destiny. The Queen of Cups is you're happy, you're stable, you're emotional. But this is all about the money. But what's the Queen of Swords in reverse here? What's that? I kind of feel it, but let me see. Yeah. Yep. Okay. Let's say you suspect this person is stealing from you, or let's say you suspect this of being a bad contract. Just be diplomatic, I guess, politically correct, whatever that is in the way that you handle that. You don't want to have regrets and you don't want to be disappointed. You will if you're too harsh with the way, you know, let's say this is the president of the music company that's giving you a contract. You don't want to march in their office and be like, you motherfucker, this isn't a fair deal. You just want to kind of delicately say, hey, you know, I don't really like the way this is going for me. You know, my lawyer reviewed this. What does this terminology mean? Can you explain that to me? Can you, you know, just kind of be smart about those decisions, because I feel there's, well, like Biggie says, more money, more problems. And that's what I feel like. You're coming into some serious success, but there's just someone who's trying to take advantage of you. Someone who's trying to get their hands on your money here. I can't believe this is coming up, but that's what's coming up. And this is about regrets and disappointment. If you handle it the wrong way. So it's just all about being smart, making sure that you're the right people are helping you and the right contracts are being presented. Sign them. Before you sign them, have a lawyer review them. Just make sure it's fair and it benefits you, because we have a leveling up here. You have a serious like, let's say you're getting your promotion to the president of your company. Well, make sure there's not a little clause in there that you know, any bonus you get doesn't go to you, it goes to your boss or something really stupid, you know what I mean? Or if the profits increased 50%, you know, their boss gets, you know, time sharing and profit sharing, but you don't. Whatever that is, just make sure it's fair for you, and be diplomatic when you're dealing with the clauses in your contracts. That's what they want to say. But this is your destiny. This is a major leveling up. This is major success for you here in June. This is a really excellent reading, minus the person trying to steal from you. But just be careful with that. That's what I got for you, Sag. So, Sag, I hope you enjoyed your reading. If you like my style, I do ask that you like, comment, subscribe. Helps my channel to grow. Thank you for the support. Let's close your reading off today with a yes or no question. So if the card comes in reverse, it's a no. If the card comes upright, it's a yes. Let's get the answer to your question. The answer is a yes. That's what I got, Sajay. I wish you the best of luck. Until next time.